In the previous videos, you sent an email to your partner or yourself. You practiced opening emails and responding to them. In this video, you will learn how to determine an email's credibility. You will decide which emails to keep and which to delete. Remember that you should only open emails from trustworthy senders. Some people will try to use email to trick you into giving them your personal details, passwords, or financial information by pretending to be someone you know. You might get an email that looks like it is from a well-known online retailer. Inside, it might say that you need to enter your credit card information to complete an order. You might get similar email requests from what seem to be banks or government agencies, like the IRS. This is called phishing, and it is illegal. To avoid being the victim of a phishing scheme, review the sender and subject lines for all the emails you receive. To start, open your Gmail account in a new tab. Keep this video open in a separate tab so you can easily go back and forth between the two. As you've learned previously, every email includes the name of the sender and a subject line. After completing the other videos in this activity, you should have received several emails. When you send yourself an email, you will see your name listed as the sender. You know that you are a trustworthy source and whether you've sent yourself a message. So it's safe to open this email. Friends, family members, classmates, and coworkers are all usually safe sources as well. If you've given your email address to a store, organization, or website, you may be on their email list. They might send you coupons, invites to special events, or updates on the group's activities. The name of the group should be listed as the sender. Emails from a known sender are usually safe to open. But be cautious when clicking any links inside, opening attachments, or giving out your personal information. Phishing schemes often ask for money, bank information, credit card numbers, personal information such as a social security or ID number, or passwords. Never give out this information over email, even if you think you know the sender. If you don't recognize the name of the person who sent the email, consider whether the person is trustworthy. If you're not sure, review the subject line. It's a good idea to review the subject line for all emails you receive, even if you think you know the sender. Even trusted senders can have their email accounts stolen or hacked. Internet scam emails and websites often look legitimate at first, but if you look closely, something isn't quite right. If you hover over the email address, it might show that it isn't really from your friend or the company it says it is. If you receive an email that you think might be untrustworthy, do not open it. Delete it from your inbox. To do this, check the box next to the email, then delete it. If you delete an email by accident, recover it by looking in your trash folder. Check the box next to the email you want to take out of the trash. Then, use the folder management button to move the email back to your inbox. Another option for removing untrustworthy emails is to mark them as spam. Spam is the junk mail in your email inbox. When you mark something as spam, it is removed from your inbox and reported as an unsafe message. Check the box next to the email you think is unsafe. Then report it as spam. Nice work! You've learned to manage your email inbox by finding appropriate messages and deleting spam. Now it's your turn. Review the emails in your inbox to make sure the senders and subject lines are trustworthy. Delete emails you don't need. Mark junk emails as spam. Move on to the next video.